this video is a group assignment. We are required to tell or share true story about accident involving airplane. This assignment is for activity marks for the subject of aviation safety and security. So, have you ever had the story about the disaster, Air India Flight 182 disaster? Must you never heard, right? So, the incident took place on 23 June 1985, where a passenger jet exploded off the coast of Ireland. This incident has claimed the life of all passengers and crew members. In this incident, Sikh extremists were accused of sabotaging the Air Indian aircraft, and one suspect was convicted in 2003. The flight started from Toronto to London directly to Bombay. After a routine stop in Montreal, where Canadian officially removed three suspicious baggage from the aircraft, the flight departed for London as scheduled and established communication with Heathrow Airport Towers. But just 45 minutes from its destination, the jet disintegrated in midday. No warning or emergency call were issued as the plane disappeared from radar screen. Heathrow staff dispatched emergency rescue crew, but no survivors were found. Only 131 bodies were retrieved from the sea. So, for more information about Air India Flight 182 disaster, will be explained by my teammate. Stay tuned, guys.
Hi, my name is Muhammad Hanafi bin Johari. I'm holding matric number in D4190782G. Today, I would like to talk about the story of the incident in sabotage bomb explosion on board Air India Flight 182. The story is about the Flight 182 was en route from Toronto to London, continuing to Bombay, is at Mumbai. After a routine stop in Montreal, where Canadian officials removed the three suspect baggage from the aircraft, the flight departed for London as scheduled and established communication with Heathrow Airport staff. Just 45 minutes from its destination, the jet disintegrated in mid-air. No warning or emergency calls were issued. As the plane disappeared from radar screens, Heathrow staff dispatched emergency rescue crew, but no survivors were found. Only 131 bodies were retrieved from the sea. The causes of the crash was not immediately known, but airline officials suspect Sikh extremists of planting a bomb on the aircraft. In the early 1980s, India was embroiled in violent civil unrest between Sikh and Hindu factions. 5 months after the disaster, two suspects were arrested. Canadian police believe that one of the suspects is Talwinder Singh Parmar, had masterminded the attack, but charges against him were ultimately dropped. He was later killed by the police in India. Another suspect, Indrajit Singh Riyad, a Sikh residing in Vancouver. In Vancouver, eventually pleaded guilty to manslaughter in connection with the bombing and was sentenced to 5 years in prison in 2003. Riyad previously had been sentenced to 10 years in prison for helping to build a bomb that killed two baggage handlers at Japan's Narita Airport at the same day as the Flight 182 disaster. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Puteri Nalana Safa binti Muhammad. I hold the matric number of DK2006255 and I'm the third presenter. So today, my topic is how many people died Air India Flight 182 disaster. Passenger jet exploded off the coast of the Iran on June 23, 1985, that claimed the life of all 329 passengers and crew members. Site extremists were the causes of the sabotage. The Air India aircraft and one suspect was convicted in 2003.
So my name is Aiman Sharafi bin Saunizan. I'm holding a matric card number D4190785C. So as a result of the explosion from a bomb planted by Canadian Sikh extremists known commonly as Khalistanis, who were involved in the Khalistan movement. So he was sentenced to 15 years in prison for assembling the bombs that exploded on board Air India Flight 182 and at Narita. Their subsequent investigation and prosecution last almost 20 years. This was the most expensive trial in Canadian history, costing nearly $130 million Canadian. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Rabia Tadawiyah binti Abdul Halim. My lucky number is D form 2069 and 28. So today I want to talk about the causes of incident Air India Flight 182. The equator of Ripudaman Singh Malik, which is Malik, and Ajaib Singh Bagri, which is Bagri, brought many memories flooding back. It also arose again the sense of grief, anger, and frustration which they experienced from that moment in June 1985, when they realized that their loved one has been killed. There are issues about the response of Canadian government agencies to the bombing, which clearly warrant further review. Not at all issues should be the focus of an inquiry, because they are very broad and some are already subject of widespread public debate. As Justice Joseph Soin determined in his reasons for judgment, the conspiracy to bomb the two Air India flight involved individuals belonging to what became known as the Babar Khalsa movement, a group of Sikh radicals determined to purify the Sikh religion and establish an independent homeland for Sikh in Punjab, India. The families told that they believe Canada must do more to deal with force of extremism, even hard within communities that have made this country their home. They believe that Canada's politicians have not been sufficiently sensitive to the risk of festering solitudes within communities breaking out into violence. So they pointed to the evidence of a culture of fear within communities that has stopped people telling the truth about what happened. Two potential witnesses in the Malik and Bagri trials were killed. The murders, while still under active investigation, have not yet led to criminal charge. Kim Boland, a reporter with the Vancouver Sun, has written a recent book on Air India that documents many efforts at silencing and intimidating her and others in the Sikh community critical of extremism. These issues are not unique to any one community. To make them the subject of a public inquiry would be a vast and unmanageable exercise, but they need to be the subject of continuing government review and action. Canadians should be able to express their opinions without fear of intimidation. Charitable organizations should not be abused. The law in this matter is clear enough. It should be enforced. The wide debate that has engulfed many countries about the potential for terrorist attack has very naturally deeply affected those whose lives have been shattered by the Air India bombing. This is not so much a subject for an inquiry as it is far deeper searching, in which all Canadians and their political leaders need to engage. Why did the murder of 331 people do no more to shake our complacency? The families have also expressed their deep hurt at their isolation from their fellow Canadians. There was little recognition of their loss. The civil lawsuit dragged on for some years until being settled in 1991. Emotional and psychological support was hard to find. Canadians did not embrace this disaster as their own. 20 years after the bombing, and with the support of the BC Attorney General, Family members produce a book of memorial to their loved one. It is impossible to open the book at any page and not feel the deepest sense of loss and hurt. Whole families, even children of promise, parents of achievement and kindness were murdered. What happened was not an incident, no conflict in any homeland, no religious or ethnic dispute, no ideology can justify what happened. Many Canadians think that it was 9/11 that initiated us into the modern world of terrorism. It should have been June 23, 1945. So that's all for me. Thank you.
My name is Ahmad. Today we'll talk about the conclusion of the bombing of Air Indian Flight 182. The Air Indian is a airline company by India, and their first stopover is London Heathrow Airport, and second stopover is Palam International Airport, India, and their final destination is Sahar International Airport. Okay, as you can see, this plane has got so many passengers in their plane. The number of passengers is 392 passengers, and the crew is only 22 in the plane. Okay, so the question is, from this story, we know the plane has been bombed in what we call Atlantic Ocean Sea, and it was bombed by Khalistani terrorists, Canadian Khalistani terrorists, Inderjit Singh. And for your information, the suspect of this incident is Inderjit Singh, a dual British-Canadian citizen, was pleaded guilty in 2003 and was sentenced in prison for 50 years. As you can know, for us, 50 years is quite short for someone that has bombed so many passengers and that no survivor at all. And because of this, the regulation body in aviation industry has created so many steps to prevent unlawful accident, and also all the incident that happened in aviation industry that has already affected in our life. So because of this, the regulation creates so many, such as NX, NX70, NX19, so many NX to prevent unlawful accident. And all the regulation, all the aviation industry people need to follow the regulation and law. And because air transportation is the safest air transportation in the world, right? Ground transport, water transport, air transportation. These three transport, number one is air transportation. And if they want to keep this air transportation safer, they need to prevent unlawful accident by doing some law to make sure there is no unlawful accident happen. And I think that's all from me. Thank you.